9:41. Thanks for being with us on Live at 9. She's an award-winning writer who uses humor and her life here in the South to tell her stories.
And now Ellen Morris Prewitt has a debut novel. It's called Tracking Happiness, A Southern Chicken Adventure.
Love that name.
Thank you.
So you have written extensively, short stories, essays, won awards. Your first novel, though.
It is.
And is this an expanded version of a short story from before, or what?
No, it's not. I have written a novel that was, but this one just came out of the blue. I gave myself a challenge to write a novel in a limited period of time. And so I just took, like you said, things from my life and jumbled them all together and came up with a story.
Good thing you've had an interesting life.
Yeah. So was this done over a period of time? I know we just mentioned about those short stories, or was this a several year project that was continued to be worked on while you're doing your other things?
I am slow as molasses, and I will get it out there, and it's great, and I think it's finished. But then I really have to work with it for a long time to get to where the story needs to be. And so this one, I'm gonna say maybe even 12 years.
Wow.
Now, while I was doing that, I'm writing all kinds of other things.
Yeah.
In that same period, I've done like 7 other novels. This is my 4th book.
Well, this sounds quirky. So tell us the story without giving too much away.
It's like people say quirky, zany. It's like, okay.
A little eccentric.
It's Southern. it starts out with a drug scandal erupting at the local fried chicken joint,
okay,
which was started by Lucinda's beloved but deceased daddy.
Okay.
And his running buddy.
And is it still in the family, the chicken joint?
The local chicken joint is.
Okay.
His partner, Big Doodle, went on to take the chicken palace.
I'm sorry, only in the South.
Are they franchising that? Because I think I'd like one of those.
I know, Big Doodle. And there are a lot of chicken jokes, I have to warn you, in this book. But he took it big all over the Southeast.
Okay.
And then, of all things, he is accusing Lucinda's daddy of being the mastermind behind this drug ring at the local chicken palace. So Lucinda decides to go on a train trip with her friend who's going up to Minnesota to visit his family with the intent to get off in Chicago and confront Big Doodle at the Chicken Palace convention and make him take back what he said about her daddy.
I hear about a lot of dramatic actors saying comedy is so much harder than drama. So when writing, and you know, I don't know if you're trying to be funny, is that the same way? Is it just as difficult to try to make things funny and not like just silly?
I have a very odd sense of humor, and I have come to realize that because so many people have told me that. And so it comes very naturally to me. I think humor often is undervalued.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, the humor is a vehicle. You know, you're laughing, you think this is the funniest thing, and then before you know it, you've gotten attached to Lucinda, and what is it that she's really trying to work on? And,
yeah.
And what is she going to figure out while she's on this train trip? Well,
if you have a character named Big Doodle in it, hard not to be funny.
Lucinda.
Hard not to laugh at that.
Big Doodle.
So what if there's one thing that you hope people get from it? What is that underlying message?
Well, what she is trying to do is work out the grief from her daddy dying that she has never focused on full face on.
Gotcha.
And she's kind of gone off in all these other directions, trying to deal with it. And so what she is trying to discover is, how do you regain happiness after you've had a life altering event?
And that would be a good thing for all of us to learn.
Yes, and so I hope that's what
So we put on the screen, you can come out tonight.
8 o'clock.
At Novel, and they will have the heat
6 o'clock.
For you.
Six o'clock, thank you. See, that's what happens. Yeah. My eyes were gone here.
Thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome.
Such
and I
a
have
pleasure.
That's your book and your little fluffy chickens. We're going to be giving those away at the book signing.
Oh, awesome.
Yes.
You got a free fluffy chicken.
Thank you so
from
much.
From Big Noodle himself.
Thank y'all for having me.
Thank you.